Avicanna, Aras Azadian, is here with us at SmallCapPower. Aras, thank you so much.
A pleasure. How are you doing?
Can you introduce us to Avicanna? What's your line of business?
Sure. So Avicanna is a biotech company specialized in cannabinoids. So we've been working for the last 3 years with some of the top medical institutions in Canada, UHN, University of Toronto, to establish our own platform of medical devices, deliveries, formulations related to cannabinoids, even cosmetic skincare. We've developed all those products, and now we're in the process of commercializing them in a number of jurisdictions around the world. We also cultivate in Colombia, where we believe we have competitive advantage in cultivating the cannabis as a plant, because we extract the entire plant and isolate the cannabinoids. We have a significant cost difference or cost advantage over our Canadian or American counterparts. So we do a lot of the cultivation, extraction, manufacturing there. The research development, clinical development is done here in Canada. And we, from Colombia, under GMP conditions, export to around the world.
A lot of the focus and excitement in the run-up to legalization is about the cultivators and the flower. But explain to us, what's the potential in terms of the derivatives, the extracts, the products that you're talking about?
So I think the medical marijuana industry is very different than the recreational marijuana industry. And sooner or later, the recreational one will be mainly focused on flower and, you know, the flower derivatives. I think the local growers will do substantially better with local markets. Where at a pharmaceutical, cosmetic, nutraceutical, medical perspective, if you're taking those cannabinoids and you're creating stabilized products that have clinical evidence, they're valid in whatever jurisdiction they can be exported to, there's less limitations with respect to the markets you can enter. So once a product becomes pharmaceutical, it's very different than flower, which could be utilized more at a recreationally. And flower doesn't have the same shelf life stability as a stabilized medical or pharmaceutical product. So that's why I think, again, flower growers, cultivators will do well if they're focused recreationally, locally.
What's stimulating growth at the company?
So we've been a biotech company from the beginning, but once we attained our cultivation license and became vertically integrated in Colombia, I think that changed things. That gave us further valuation and also validation of our ability to execute internationally. So that's been key. But we today have 25 PhDs in the company. We're very strictly involved in medical development and intellectual property development. So in the near future, we're going to be having our first harvest, our first product launches, our first clinical trials, our first hopefully FDA-approved product. So there's a lot of growth drivers there, but we're also looking to go public. We're submitting to do an IPO in the CSE sometime in Q4 this year, so we look forward to that, of course.
Take us behind the scenes of your management expertise. What has been your background and other people on your team?
Sure. So my entire company is made up of professional executives. Everyone in the company either comes from a management consulting background, legal background, or a scientist. As I mentioned, I have 25 doctors on board, about 8 MDs and 14 or so PhDs. Everyone else is MBA lawyers. So we've taken a very, very professional approach, which I think is better suited for our pharmaceutical medical sort of division that we're going after, where that may be a little bit different than most recreationally focused medical marijuana or marijuana companies that have come from capital markets, mining, or even illegal cannabis cultivation practices.
Over the long term, investors would like to see operational efficiency from companies that impress them. How prepared are you to meet those goals?
That's what we're aiming for, you know, and I think sooner or later fundamentals are going to have to matter, and that's what we're doing. We're cultivating with the world's largest organic industrial scale agricultural company, and that's what they do. We're a pharma company, that's what we do. So we're looking at operational efficiency at all stages of the verticals of the business, and because we own the IP, we own the API, we own the brands, we own the entire vertical, I think our margins are going to be substantial at each stage of the business. That will show real competitive advantage on all levels of the business. So I think efficiency will certainly be there.
What's the status of finances in this sector? Is institutional money coming in?
For us, yes, but I think it's a fairly easy sector to raise money in, fortunately. And I come from a biotech background. My own personal experience has been in oncology, specifically speaking, and biotech's a very tough sector to raise money on. But if you add cannabis to the name, it becomes a lot easier. So we're utilizing the fact that we are still a cannabis company, but while we're biotech, we're looking at other technologies that aren't necessarily cannabis-driven, but have access to the capital markets with respect to cannabis.
Do you think your strength in biotech is going to differentiate you from others and create this separate brand identity?
Absolutely. I think we already have. I think we're very well respected in Canada as perhaps the most advanced biotech from a biotech pharmaceutical development level. We work with the top medical institution in the country and the top academic institution, the University of Toronto. So I think that has differentiated us, and it will continue to do that because it's a long-term business model. You know, our clinical trials are going to take 3 to 4 years for some indications. Some are orphan drugs, so they're 2 years, but that process is a much more long-term business model. So if whoever is involved in our business model realizes it's a very long-term play, and that's why we're here to do.
Any plans to go public?
Yes, that's what, as I was alluding earlier, we're going to be public on the CSE by the end of this year, so Q4. We're going to be doing an IPO.
Excellent. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.